Hey everyone, welcome back to Wicket, and today I thought I'd do another match review for the T20 World Cup. So today we had Bangladesh versus the Netherlands, an interesting encounter to say the least. Obviously Bangladesh walked away with the victory, but I don't think they'll be completely happy with how they got that victory. They started off not bad. Shanto was looking quite good, hitting a lot of boundaries. Sumyasak was looking okay, and they started off well. You're thinking Bangladesh is going good, but typical Bangladesh as they are, and I do follow Bangladesh myself, so I know they just collapsed out of nowhere to 5 for 70 odd, and it was looking real trouble, honestly, because two of their most informed batsmen in Litton Das and Shakib Al Hasan got dismissed quite quickly, one after the other, and all of a sudden I thought, oh my god, are we going to get embarrassed by the Netherlands here? And yeah, luckily, thank god, Afif Hussain came in and clutched and got a pretty good knock. He ended up getting 38, and Mossadegh applied some finishing touches, finishing with 20 himself. The position that they were in, a lot of them probably didn't need to play the shots that they did. Netherlands came in to bat, and Tuskin Ahmed, I can't say enough about this guy. He's improved so much in the last year or two. He's taking his bowling to a whole new level. He's bowling rapid. He's bowling better lengths than he used to. He's swinging it around, and he's analysing decks really quickly. Like, you can notice he's pushing his length back if it's bouncy, he's pushing it fuller if it's a bit more in the wicket. And today, yeah, masterful opening the bowling. Got the first 2 and 2 balls and really shook the Netherlands. Then he ended up with 4 for 25. Brilliant stats for him. His best ever figures in T20 cricket. And the rest of the bowlers chipped in well. Hassan Mahmood has continued his decent run of form in T20 cricket, picking up 2 wickets himself. One, I guess, really good thing to mention for Bangladesh was their fielding was outstanding today. For something that Bangladesh is always criminal of, is fielding horribly, dropping important catches when they need to take them. But today they were on point. They got 2 runouts in the same over, and both were pretty good runouts, albeit Netherlands sort of throwing the wickets away there. A short mention to Colin Ackerman, a really good knock from him. He kept Netherlands in it the whole way. Bangladesh looked like they had ripped through Netherlands like halfway through that innings, 15 overs through. You thought Netherlands are done for, there's no chance they can get close. And the fact that they got within 10 runs shows their true ability to not give up. And the fact that in this T20 World Cup, you can't take any team for granted. Any team can beat any team. You just never know, in this format especially. Then he got dismissed, and they were only on, I think, 101 at that stage, with him getting 60 of them, and he thought, 9 down, it's done. It's surely done. They're going to get bowled out now. But no, the 10th wicket partnership took it to 135, and there was definitely some Bengali fans who were scared of something incredible happening. Thank God Virat Kohli wasn't batting there, because that would have been an easy victory if it was. And yeah, the Netherlands tail. The Netherlands can take a lot of positives from this game. They bowled extremely well, keeping Bangladesh to a low total. And they fought valiantly with the bat. They'll be annoyed that their top order didn't score too many runs, but they'll take a lot of pride that they took Bangladesh so far in an encounter where probably most people thought Bangladesh have it in the bag before the game started. So let me know in the comments below what you thought of this game and the result. And until next time, I'll see you guys later.